Well, they actually first appeared not visually, but sound. They were born from a number one song that my dad wrote called The Chipmunk Song in 1958. A few years later, my dad did an animated primetime TV show called The Alvin Show. And that was the first time we saw them in an animated form. My dad created the Chipmunks. It really was Alvin and Dave's show and that interaction.
What are you writing?
Nothing.
Well, don't just stand there. Write something.
And of course, that kind of drive your parent crazy character of Alvin was born.
The great inventor Thomas Alva.
No.
Alexander Graham.
No.
Well, then who?
Clyde Crash Cop.
The essence of Alvin is that Alvin truly believes he's got a new, brilliant idea that's going to be a win-win for everybody, including Dave. So, you know, there's just no end to the stuff that Alvin will come up with.
Okay, what do you want us to do?
Clearly, if you would say, who's mischief maker number one, hard not to start with the beginning of the alphabet.
Dave needs a little help from the Love Doctor.
Watch the old maestro at work.
Uh-oh!
Alvin!
Okay!
Wow!
What's the matter, Dave? Don't you trust me?
Why can't he listen?
Blood
is
coming!
Huh? Alvin!
Oh boy, I suddenly got really, really tired. Night, Dave.
You believed the exasperation of this man dealing with an out-of-control young chipmunk.
Alvin!
Who still had a heart. You still liked Alvin, even though he was pushing that envelope. You liked this little character, and you believed that the father, the David Seville, was having a real issue. So it was all based for me on this truth. Like, I believed it.
And that was really the show. And as Janice and I took it over in 1980, we wanted a more classic form, and Janice really redesigned that whole look. And originally I was, oh my gosh, we can't change this. This is what my dad's done. It's gonna be, you know, sacrilegious. Come on, Jan. But once she did it, I loved it, and so did millions of others.
I told you it would work.
Well, back in the 60s, it was a very stylized look, as I wanted them to be more classic. And when I was a little girl, I used to look at David Seville, and he had these little legs and this really booming voice.
Arrest that eagle!
And I used to think, I wish his legs were sturdier. So I said to my mother, I don't believe that that voice is coming out of those little legs. So I was actually thinking of redesigning David Seville when I was a little girl. And so I made him look like Ross. And the Chipmunks went through several iterations, but we established a look. And Ross was just very generous in allowing me to rework them.
Stylish, yet functional. I like it.
Janice and I were probably thinking about creating a live-action Chipmunk film about 15 years ago. We had done an animated feature film that was released in 1987, The Chipmunk Adventure, so that was a wonderful experience.
What could be better?
But we wanted to see what it would be like to have the Chipmunks in this live-action world, and what would they look done in CGI. So, you know, Janice helped design the Chipmunks for the first film. She knew that they had to be real enough looking like Chipmunks that you would believe them in a live-action world, but they had to have enough of the essence of Alvin, Simon, and Theodore, so an audience who had followed them for basically three generations would see Alvin, Simon, and Theodore. So that was the trick.
The great thing about the chipmunks is that they're malleable, and whatever year we're at, they're present and available.
This'll be a walk in the park.
I mean, I think the reason why the Chipmunks franchise, empire, as some might call it, has been so successful and long-lasting is because it truly is an inspired idea.
Alvin?
Anything cute, fuzzy, furry, that can talk, but more importantly, cause a lot of trouble, kids can identify.
Whoa. Hey guys, I have an idea for a new song.
Hey, Dave.
Kids and people just, I think they're just relatable characters, and I don't think it matters how old you are, because obviously, to span this long, that it's just, I don't know, it's just a thing that people relate to.
Ross and Janice, they love this franchise, and they love the chipmunks, and they treat them like human beings.
Simon, does this make my butt look smaller?
Theodore, your butt looks fine. Those guys are just jerks.
They care about the story and the characters having entire arcs, and they want to be storytellers.
It seems like they are really filling one of those gaps where there are so few characters for young kids to fall in love with that have good hearts and are kind and compassionate, and I realize that we all could use a little more of that.
Our brother Alvin couldn't be here today. The thing is, we've never performed without Alvin, and we're not starting now.
I think they're very family, you know what I mean? And they're, even though they're chipmunks, they're real people almost, you know? They go through real issues that kids go through and can relate to, and family issues and things like that.
Guys, I want to go home. What do you mean? You are home.
No, I mean home, you know, with Dave.
I think they last because for us, they're real. And so they deal with real issues and they deal with real emotions.
Dave, are you still mad at us?
And those emotions don't get old. You can go to the beginning of time. You still want love. You still feel guilty when you get in trouble.
So you know about me playing in the house, right?
Right.
It's still that dynamic. But they're human emotions, and those don't change over the years.
Think I'll take that hug.
And I think that emotional connection and that brotherhood, sibling rivalry, and yet still at the end of the day, you know they are really a close family. It is what folks connect with.
You came back for us.
Well, of course I came back. We're a family.
Holy nuts.
I really missed you guys.
Me too.
Dave?
Yes, Alvin?
Now can I steer? Oh, please, please, please.
Have at it, fellas.
Come on, Dave, go faster.
Not with you steering.
Dave, you drive like a sleepy old bear.
Okay, Alvin, that's enough.
Enough of what? Of being awesome?